Hello friends, welcome back. It's me Sinto and this is my Nano Planter aquarium. I have been keeping this aquarium for about 4 years now and I like the plant growth and the overall look of this planted aquarium. This is one of my favorite aquarium beside the saltwater aquarium which I like the most. Though you can keep big fishes in the saltwater aquarium, but it is more tedious than this Nano Planter aquarium. In planted aquarium, you cannot keep big fishes, you cannot keep turtles or anything like that because they tear off the plants and it will create a mess. Mostly you can add the schooling fishes like neon tetras and various similar fishes. Now the beauty of the planted aquarium lies in the manner you do the aquascaping. Now aquascaping is a completely different art. It is basically the manner you put the rocks, you lay down the soil, and which all plants you plant in which all directions. There are basically the foreground plants, midground plants and the background plants. You can arrange all these things in a very interesting manner to create a beautiful aquascape. Like here you can see that I have dwarfed Sagittaria in the foreground and there is Anubias Nana Gold in the midground. There is also some grasses, baby tears, and also Marimo moss ball. At the background you can see that there is jungle wall. Now if you are also trying to keep a nano planted aquarium, I want to give you some suggestions about this aquarium from my own experience. When I was a beginner, I started planting various plants in the aquarium, but they were not growing out. They were fading out or developing yellow leaves and various other things. So I started concentrating on three aspects: the CO2, the lightning, the fertilizers, and also the number of fishes in the aquarium. For CO2, I started using do-it-yourself CO2 diffuser set. I already made a video about it. If you want to know more about it, I have added a video in the cards. You can check it out from the cards popping above. Now there is both expensive CO2 diffuser set and the cheap do-it-yourself CO2 diffuser set. I started with the cheap do-it-yourself CO2 diffuser set and it boosted my plant growth. So even the hard plants like baby deer started growing after I started using do-it-yourself CO2 diffuser set. So I strongly recommend a CO2 supply for the planted aquarium if you are starting out with planted aquarium. It is not required for all the plants. There are some plants that grow without CO2, but most of the beautiful plants in the planted section grow with CO2 supply. Now next is the lightning. It is very important for the plant growth. I use the lightning only when I supply CO2 to the planted aquarium. Now as far as the fertilizers are concerned, I have some fertilizers from the Seachem. Mostly I use the potassium and iron. If you have bigger planted aquarium, then you can use other nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, carbon, etc. Now as far as the fishes are concerned, in planted aquarium you can only keep peaceful fishes. Aggressive fishes will tear out the plants and create a mess in the aquarium. So peaceful and schooling fishes like neon tetras, golden algae eaters and various similar fishes are good for the planted aquarium. So if you have any doubts or suggestion about this planted aquarium or just planted aquarium in general, then leave it out in the comment section below. I definitely look into it. So these are my discus fish breeding pair with their discus fish fries. This is the third batch and in the third batch only few discus fish fries have been developed compared to the previous one where it was 20 and more. So after 2 weeks I will separate them to a separate grow out tank. Now they are now only 2 weeks old, so they are feeding off from their parents' skin. This is my grow out tank of discus fish fries. So lot of fish are there in this grow out tank. Sadly there is no light in this aquarium, it has been damaged.
Hey, look at those discus fish. They are looking like golden colors. So I'm cleaning my breeding tank. There is a lot of waste here. I think they shit a lot of things here. So I have to clean every 3 days. The third batch of discus flies, as you can see, are attached to the parents. So let's clean it up for them. Oh, there is a cute cat. Cat, what you are doing?
I told you earlier that I have a female cat that I got nearby KFC restaurant. She gave birth to 3 kittens 2 months back. This is one of them. So these are the kittens about 2 months back. I posted a video about it. They have now grown out. All 3 of them have grown out. And they are now 2 months old now. So I fed them special cat foods and they are okay now.
Beautiful kitty, beautiful kitty. You are the most beautiful kitty. Show me your face. Show me your face. There you go.
One more cat. She is hiding. So the 3 kittens have grown up. Hopefully I will get some buyers to give them a new home. Who knows what their life will be. This one is the cutest cat. He has blue eyes. Oh my god, I left it here. Okay, let's clean it up. So I'm filling water back in. The tubeless is haunted. I don't know. After every 3 minutes it starts blinking. So here it is. The breeding tank is clean and the water is filling up. Hey guys, bad news. One of my discus in the grow out tank died. So I separated them to a separate aquarium. And I have put some methylene blue in the grow out tank. I added the metoglyl medicines, but it doesn't help it. So yeah, feeling very bad about it. That's it for this video. I have lots of other cool videos for you to check out. Thanks for watching so far. I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, bye and take care.